Hello guys, welcome to my channel HVI Tutorials. In this video, we will discuss about what is meant by a CSS selector and what are the different types of CSS selector available. So before moving further, first let us understand why we need to learn about CSS selectors first. So in Selenium, if you want to find out an element, how you will do it? We will do it with the help of element finding strategies, nothing but locators, right? So Selenium is providing us some locators and we use those locators to find any element in the web page. So Selenium is providing us about 8 locators. So those are ID, name, class name, tag name, link text, partial link text, then XPath, and the last one is CSS selector. Yes, we are talking about the CSS selector. The CSS selector is also one of the locator among 8 locators provided by Selenium. For example, if you are able to identify any element in the web page uniquely by just using those basic locators like ID, name, class name, link text, then you might not require any CSS selector or XPath or anything, okay? Because we are good to go in that case itself. We have the unique element and we can perform the operations on that element. But what if you are not able to identify that unique element? Then we have to combine multiple properties, or we have to take the help of the other element, like based on the other element reference, we have to find out this element. So in those cases, basically, we go for two types of locators. Those are XPath and CSS selector. So this XPath and CSS selector helps us in combining the properties and help us find an element in a unique manner. Or it helps us in finding the element based on the other element reference. Okay. So in my earlier videos, we have already seen how we can use XPath and what are the different types of XPath and how we write the XPath. Everything we have seen. If you haven't watched my previous video yet, please click on this link so that you can watch those videos. Okay. So we have already completed the XPath and now we will look at the CSS selector. If you want to know anything about the CSS selector, first we should know what exactly the CSS selector is and how we are going to use it. Till now we have already seen why we need to use it. We are going to use this because Selenium is providing this CSS selector as one element finding strategy. So using this also we can able to identify the elements in the web page. So if you don't have the unique elements, obviously you have to go for XPath or CSS selector. So if you are not much familiar with the XPath, then you have the only one option, that is CSS selector. And also for some of the basic things like finding an element just with an ID or just by combining ID and class name. So those things can be achieved very easily using CSS selector. Some people feel like XPath is a difficult one and wherein CSS selector is the easiest one. So the people who are coming from the development background, they feel CSS selector is the easiest one because they might have already worked with the CSS and styling the documents and everything. So there they are going to use the CSS selector only. So those people feel like this CSS selector is the easiest way of handling the things. Okay. So now we will look at this one. So what is CSS selector? A CSS selector is a pattern used to select the element you want to style or to find the elements in the web page that you want to perform the actions. So the first one here, the one which is in red color, this suits to web development point of view. Means you are finding the elements that you want to style. You know, right? Basically, we use the CSS for applying the styles in a web page. Means you will change the look and feel of the controls and the web page by applying the CSS. So if you want to apply the CSS, then you will first find out the element, then you will apply. So in that scenario, we use the CSS selector. And we also use the CSS selector from the testing point of view, from the Selenium point of view, we use this CSS selector to find the elements, then we perform the actions on those elements like click operation, send keys operation, and getting the text of that element or any other things, right? So how many types of CSS selectors we have? We have around 5 types of CSS selector, but I have mentioned only 4 types here. That is because the other type is not being used in the Selenium. So that is being mostly used by the web developers, not for us. So here we have CSS simple selector, CSS pseudo-class selectors, CSS combinator selectors, and CSS attribute selectors. So if you look at the first one, the simple selectors. So basically selector is a pattern which we write to find out the element. So the simple selectors means we write the pattern using the basic simple attributes like ID and class. So if you are writing any selector, any pattern by using these ID and class name, then we call them as simple selectors, and this also include universal selector and element tag name selector. Okay, so those comes under simple selectors. Then comes the pseudo class selectors. So the pseudo class selectors contains like location basis and position based things. Like if you want to find out any element based on its index, or if you want to find out last child in the one parent, okay? Or if you want to find the first child, in those scenarios, we use pseudo-class selectors. Then comes the combinator selectors. So as I said, if you're not having any attributes to the element, then we have to take the help of other element and we need to find out the current element, right? So in those cases, we are building a relationship between the target element and the current element, okay? So those scenarios, we use these combinator selectors. And the last one is CSS attribute selectors. So using this one, we can able to identify any element by using attribute values. Okay. So here in the CSS simple selectors, we have already discussed like we can find out any element using ID and class. So these are the simple attributes, right? Apart from these, we have so many attributes. Like for example, if you take an image, it has SRC and it has title when it comes to text box, max length, value, placeholder. So all those things are also called attributes only, right? So using those attributes, if you want to find out any element, then we use attribute selectors. So in this attribute selectors, you no need to pass the entire value. We have functions to pass a partial attribute value also. Like if you want to find out an element using starting text only, the attribute starting text. Or if you want to find out an element using attribute ending text. For example, you have a class name like top element. Then you can pass just element and find out that element. Okay. And you can pass simply a top and you can find out that element. Okay. And you can pass the partial text also, OP. In the top, you have OP, right? You can pass that OP and find the element. So those kind of functions are also available in attribute selectors. In the upcoming videos, we will look at these simple selectors and pseudo class and combinator and attribute selectors, each and every of these selectors individually in every video. So this is about CSS selectors, guys. I hope you like the video. If you have any doubts, please let me know in the comment section below. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.
I hope you enjoy this session. If you like this video, please hit the like button and also share it with your friends. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.